which shows an observation in real time. There it was. That's, in many cases, that's all that a report may include. And in many other cases, we have far less than this. As we detailed in both the unclassified and classified versions of the preliminary assessment released by the Office of the Director of National Intelligence last June, this often limited amount of high-quality data and reporting hampers our ability to draw firm conclusions about the nature or intent of UAP. As detailed in the ODNI report, if and when individual UAP incidents are resolved, they likely fall into one of five potential explanatory categories: airborne clutter, natural atmospheric phenomena, U.S. government or U.S. industry developmental programs, foreign adversary systems, or a other bin that allows for a holding bin of difficult cases and for the possibility of surprise and potential scientific discovery. We stand by those initial results. Since the release of that preliminary report, the UAP Task Force database has now grown to contain approximately 400 reports. The stigma has been reduced. We've also made progress in resolving the character of a limited number of UAP encounters. For example, let me show you a couple of another video and image taken years apart in different areas. In this video, U.S. Navy personnel recorded what appears to be triangles, some flashing, recorded several years ago.
You know, I do believe that it's important to show that the Department of Defense has, we have character. And we're people just like you, just like the American people. We have our... We have our inquisitiveness. We have our questions. We want to know what's out there as much as you want to know what's out there. We get the questions not just from you, we get it from family members. And we get them night and day, not just in committee hearings. So finding what's out there is important. But first and foremost, it's important for us to do that so that we can ensure that our people, our personnel, our aviators, our bases and installations are safe. And then that curiosity factor is something else that that we just want to know, because that's the human race.
Mr. Krishnamurthy.
First question is, there have been no collisions between any U.S. assets and one of these UAPs, correct?
We have not had a collision. We've had at least 11 near misses, though.
And maybe we'll talk about those 11 near misses or any place where there's close proximity. I assume... or tell me if I'm wrong, there's been no attempt, there's no communications or any kind of communication signals that emanate from those objects that we've detected, correct?
That's correct.
And have we attempted to communicate with those objects?
No.
So we don't even put out a alert saying, you know, U.S., identify yourself, you are, you know.